What's going on, YouTube world and cigar enthusiasts all across the world? This is Jack, the cigar enthusiast, coming to you live from Jacksonville, Florida, where every day is a great day to have a cigar. Today, we're going over one of the topics that I talked about and the five things that you must understand when smoking a cigar for the first time. This is going in depth on the filler, the binder, and the wrapper. So if you haven't seen five things that you must understand before smoking a cigar for your first time, I highly suggest that you do so, just so you understand where I'm going with my next couple of videos. With that being said, the link is right below. Click it, watch it, then come back to this one. But before you leave, subscribe, share, and like. Buckle up, strap in, and let's go. Today we're smoking on a Habano Hand Rolled Torpedo from Eborn Cigar Plus. If you have not noticed, I changed up the scenery a little bit. I'm doing my video today in the outside simply due to the fact it's a beautiful day out in Florida. As you can see, the sun is just beaming on me. So never feel like you have an obligation to smoke a cigar at a cigar lounge. Even though smoking a cigar at a cigar lounge allows you to meet more people from different walks of life and just be able to enjoy the atmosphere of cigars, there's nothing wrong with grabbing a cigar, going to your back porch, especially if it has a view like this, and smoking a great cigar. But today we're going over the three parts of an actual cigar in detail. The three parts of a cigar is the filler, the binder, and the wrapper. I stated this again in the five things that you must understand when smoking a cigar for the first time, but today we're understanding a cigar. This is not essential to smoke a cigar, but this allows you to really understand the perfection that goes into making a cigar. So without further ado, we're gonna roll into the first part of a cigar called a filler. The filler is a very important key fact into making the cigar actually what it is. So the filler produces most of the flavor, as we learned already, and the aroma of the cigar. But we're gonna take it a step further. So there are many leaves that actually make up the filler, but there are normally three types of leaves that most tobaccoists use to create the filler. And that is a ligero, a seco, and a velado. These leaves are very important in the process of how your cigar burns, how your cigar tastes, how your cigar actually produces as a cigar. So let's go over those. A ligero is usually the top leaf of a tobacco plant. It's typically packed with a lot of flavor, a lot of boldness, because it is more exposed to the element of nature, which is typically aged for 36 months before it's even utilized in an actual cigar. The main thing you need to understand about a ligero leaf is typically in the middle of the filler. Why, you ask? Because if it's too close to the wrapper, it will cause the cigar to burn unevenly, because a ligero leaf is a more slower burning leaf. Now a seco is a lighter color leaf, and it's typically not packed with as much flavor as the ligero. The seco leaf comes from the middle of the plant and typically aged for about 18 months before it's even used in a cigar. And the last leaf they typically use is the velado. The velado has little to no flavor. It produces little to nothing to the cigar, with the exception of burn quality. Next part of a cigar is called the binder. As the name implies, the only purpose of the binder is to bind the filler together. That is it. Most of the time, most companies use a lower grade tobacco because it doesn't serve as something that's going to provide flavor to the actual cigar. The purpose and structure of the cigar, however they plan on molding the cigar, this allows us to create that mold, to create that structure that holds that cigar together, that holds the filler in place. But some of the top companies will use a higher grade of tobacco for the binder to add a little bit more flavor or boldness to the cigar in which they're producing. This is not typical. Like I said, the purpose of the binder is simply to hold the structure of the cigar, to allow the maker to create the mold in which the cigar is gonna be. Whether that's a torpedo, whether that's a box press, or a Robusto cigar. This is the purpose of it. Again, the binder is used as a structure for the cigar. And the last thing, and the most important part of a cigar, is the wrapper. Why? because this is what you're putting your mouth on. This is ultimately what's going to provide the taste of the cigar. This is what you're going to look at when it's time to actually pick out a cigar. So companies take a lot of extra precautions into making sure that those leaves located on the lower part of the tobacco plant is blemish free, because if it's not blemish free, then it's going to have a hard time actually sticking to the actual cigar. With that being said, growers take an extra precaution into cultivating and protecting those leaves to make sure that they can produce a great leaf for wrapping their cigars. Like I said, the wrapper is the presentation of the cigar. There are typically four main wrappers that they actually run to. And all those wrappers is really depending on the aging process. For a lighter color wrapper, the aging process is not gonna be as long, probably 6 to 9 months. For a darker wrapper like a Maduro, it's probably gonna be 36 to 48 months before they can even use that as a wrapper. Not every wrapper can be used as a Maduro wrapper, simply due to the fact that there's a sheen on the actual plant when it's picked. Depending on how that sheen is depending on how the oils react during the aging process. So if the oils don't react well during the aging process for Maduro, then guess what? It cannot be used. This process is very, very, very important. So those main four wrappers that you will normally see is a Connecticut, a Corojo, Bono, and Maduro. And then my next video that I post next week, they're going to go more in depth into the different type of wrappers that is used in the industry and some examples of what those wrappers look like and how to decipher those wrappers when it's time to explore different type of cigar options that's out there. Ready for next week when we talk about those different wrapper colors. Again, this is Jack the Cigar Enthusiast, and I'm gone.